Competitive diving is one of the most beautiful of Olympic sports. It requires strength, ability, and above all, courage. Up here on the 10-meter board, it takes just a second and a half before you hit the water at about 30 miles an hour. And in that second and a half, the athlete has got to do complex somersaults, twists, got to understand the height, and got to understand the angle of entry. So how does the diver do that? And that's where the coach comes in. So before the diver surfaces from the water, the coach has got to come up with the answer to the question, what do I tell my athlete?
I give them feedback that helps them achieve their goals, and that's the goals for that session, the goals for that training cycle, and ultimately the goals that will get them towards elite performance and hopefully an Olympic medal.
So Adam, we've worked together for a number of years now. We've installed 6 cameras, 4 force platforms, 2 enormous TV screens. How do you use those to help your athletes?
Well, we use it to give us lots and lots and lots of feedback. And of the different kinds of feedback we get, we can choose which ones of those the athletes respond best to and make sure they get more information in that style. In the first instance, you've got your coach's eye. You're looking at them and saying internally, that looks right, that doesn't look right, and this is why. And then the iPad and the video and the force data gives you a bit more information that says, yes, I was right with what I thought. Oh, actually, this is new information, so I'm going to turn that into a postural correction or a timing correction that's hopefully easy for the diver to make happen to get them closer to my coach's eye and my data idea of perfect.
By the time they've come up from the water, you've got all of that ready, have you?
You tap your tablet as they hit the water, that goes and grabs the last few seconds of video data. By the time the diver comes round, they can have seen their replay on the big screen, and then we can go into it in a little bit of detail with them in a way that works for them and leads to a technical change that makes them a little bit better.
Nice. A little bit more through here. Just stays there a little bit, isn't it?
Okay. I think it was more my legs did that.
Yeah, you're doing exactly the right thing. Just needs a little bit of zip so it takes that out.
So we've got the video of Ben. This is the high-speed video linked to the force plate data, and we can play the video through.
Oh, wow. I love that.
You can see the line projected on screen, and if the line's longer, he's pushing harder. And depending on what direction the line goes, that's the direction he's pushing into the tower. So here, for example, you see he's pushing back quite hard. Now, the graph up here tells the coach and the diver, if they want it, A, how hard in terms of newtons they were pushing on the tower in two different directions. So the green line shows how hard he was pushing down onto the tower. The red line shows the X direction, how hard he was pushing forwards or backwards.
Okay, let me just give that a go. That is fantastic. I love that. So having that, and having that on here by the side of the pool, being able to do that, that is just wonderful, seeing those force vectors. So what the top athlete has is instinct and judgment, but he needs more. At the elite level, you need evidence-based understanding to get those incremental changes. And it's the job of the sports engineer to take the measurements, to understand it, and to impart it back to the athlete and coach so they can be the very best that they can. I love it.